All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Chupacabra Tutorials channel. I'm your host, Larry, and today we're looking at a website called mybrandnewlogo.com, and they have a section called Discord Logo Maker. So you've got a brand new community, you're not really much of a graphic designer, or you don't have the software available to try. Well, this is free, and you can use it to make whatever you want. Let's say you have, like, All right, so the first thing we need when using the Discord Logo Maker is to have a name. So I figure, what's a better name than the Speedrunner Cafe? You know, you're a bunch of speedrunners, you love running things speedily and fast for games. You get the high score and beat it in the fastest amount of time. Let's go with that. So let's hit start. And then what is your slogan, if you want it? Let's just say that the slogan is as fast as Digi Lightning. And so the next thing is, what kind of abstract shape do you think best represents what you're doing? Up to three English keywords describing your company. Speed, lightning, what else? Race. Yeah, that'll probably work. And then let's just do surprise me as far as colors are concerned. And let's see what this logo majigger has come up with. So it looks like what this program does is it kind of takes a lot of different common icons that are associated with different types of branding and logos, and it kind of mixes and matches them to try to give you something that feels unique and relevant to you. Oh, I've got this font. This is a free font that you can grab online. It's a very excellent font. It looks like a speedometer is what it's decided to run with, although I probably would have gone more with lightning. Oh, this is actually pretty good. I like this one. It's like a... Whoa. Create a free account to save your logos. Well, hold on. I'm not done looking at them yet, man. So we got Speedrunner Cafe. This one's pretty nice. This one is nice as well. So once you've got something that you like, you can adjust the colors. You can adjust the font and layout. So let's... what looks good? I kind of like... What did I feel like would... Let's just go with this one. Let's just adjust the logo, clicking on this. So let's say the symbol I like, this font. This font isn't bad, but I don't know. What other kind of options do we have? Let's select something new. Whoa! That's one heck of a way to pick a font real quick, I tell you what. Let's just pick something that's clean and readable and not too thin. So the one that we had was good. I kind of like this one. That's the Speedrunner Cafe. And then this icon, let's just increase this a little bit. Yeah, so you can just play around with everything that's going on here. You can select a different icon if you really wanted to. Let's see if we had some options for lightning. Without misspelling lightning with a weird slash. That usually helps. Oh yeah, yeah, we got some money right here. Let's say this looks kind of digital. Let's go with that. Oh yeah, I'm loving that a little bit. Does it look like they give you a little bit of sizing options? So let's just make sure that fills the maximum amount of space, and then the rotation's fine. I'm completely fine with that. Let's click on this background image and let's go to the gradient. No, let's turn that off. And let's change the fill color to something a little bit more. Oh, that wasn't quite what I was going for. Let's put that back to white. I was trying to get this color back here. Okay, so this is just like an object that you can recolor. That's not bad. And then you can make this whatever you wanted. So what kind of color do you suppose lightning is? Like maybe... I wouldn't really go with a red. I'm more of like a green teal man myself. Maybe like that. That looks pretty good. And then let's go down to the font. What kind of color do we want for this? The fill color. Let's just make it a nice blue. A blue is always something that everybody can kind of get behind. It works no matter what you're doing. Yeah, I like that. Okay. And now if we wanted to save this, we'd have to create a free account, which I'm guessing they just want to, like, get your email so they can try to sell you a premium service. But for a quick, you know, speedily generated logo for a community, and you spent like 5, 10 minutes, maybe 20 if you really want to get nitpicky about it and play with all the different settings and effects, that's not bad. I mean, these aren't quite putting me out of work yet as a graphic designer, but this is well on its way. So check it out if you need a free logo. This is definitely a great way to do it. And then you can just snapshot this icon up here and make that your logo for your server just in the little icon box, and you'd be golden, really. I think this is a great tool. So check it out. I'll put the link in the video description. And until next time, I've been your host, Larry. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Bye, everybody, and have a good one.